What Christmas Is As We Grow Older by Charles Dickens. Time was, with most of us, when Christmas Day is circling all our limited world like a magic ring, left nothing out for us to miss or seek, bound together all our home enjoyments, affections and hopes, grouped everything, everyone round the Christmas fire, and made a little picture shine in our bright young eyes complete. Time came perhaps all too soon, when our thoughts overleapt that narrow boundary, when there was someone very dear, we thought then, very beautiful and absolutely perfect, wanting to the fulfillment of our happiness, when we were wanting to, or we thought so, which did just as well at a Christmas heath, by which that did someone sat, and where we intertwined with every wreath and garland of our life as someone's name. That was a time for bright, vigilant Christmases, with their have long arisen from us to show faintly after summer rain and palest edges of the rainbow. It was a time for the bitterfield enjoyment of the things that were meant were to be and never were, yet the things that were so real, resolute hope, that it would be hard to say now the realities achieved since have been stronger. What did Christmas never really come when we in the priceless peril, who was our young choice, we received after the happiness of a totally impossible marriages by two united families previously at daggers drawn on our account, with brothers and sisters who had always been called to us, come before our relationship was affected, coolly, perfectly doted on us, when fathers, mothers overwhelmed us with unlimited incomes. Was that Christmas dinner never really eaten, after which we arose and generously, adequately rendered honour to our light rival, present in the company, then, and having strangers' friendship and forgiveness, fanning and attachment, not to be surprised in Greek or Roman story, which persisted until death. Has the same rival long ceased to care for the same priceless pearl, married for money, come and curious? Above all, do we really know that we should probably have been miserable if he had won and won the born poor pearl? And we were better without her. Christmas, when we were recently achieved so much fame, when we had been carried in triumph somewhere, for doing something great and good, when we had won an honoured and ennobled name, arrived and was received at home in a shower of tears of joy. Possible that Christmas was not yet come. This is a life here of the best. So constituted that, pausing as we advance at such a notable milestone and track of this great birthday, we look back on the things that never were, as naturally as full as gravity, as on the things that have been and gone, have been and still are. If it be so, it seems to be, must be coming the conclusion, that life is a little better than a dream, a little worth of loves and strivings we crowd into it. No, far be such miscalled philosophy for us, dear reader. On Christmas Day, nearer and closer to our hearts be Christmas spirit, which is a spirit of active usefulness, perseverance, cheerful discharge of duty, kindness and forbearance is the last virtues of especially that we are, should be, strengthened by accomplished visions, by youth. For who shall say that we are not teachers to drill gently, even in palpable nothings of the earth? Therefore, as we grow older, let us be more thankful to the circle of our Christmas associations, lessons that they bring as bands. Let us welcome each one of them and summon them to take their places by the Christmas heath. Welcome, all apparitions, glittering creatures of ardent fancy, to your shelter underneath the holly. We know you have not outlived you yet. Welcome your projects and old loves, ever fleeting, to our nook, your nooks among the stolen lights that burn around us. Welcome all that was ever real to our hearts, and for the illness that made you real, thanks to the heaven. Do we build no Christmas castle in the clouds now? Let our thoughts fluttering like butterflies among these flowers of children bear witness. Before this boy, it stretches out a future brighter than we ever looked on our own romantic time. But bright with honour and with truth around this little head, which the sunny curls lie heaped, and graces sport as prettily, as airily, as when there was no scythe within the reach of time, shear away the curls of her first love. Upon another girl's face near it, passive and smiling bright, a quiet and contented little face, we see her loom fairly written, shining from the world as rays shine the star we see now. When our graves are old, our hopes than ours are young, our hearts than ours are moved. Now many other ways are smoothed. However, happiness blooms, ripens and glaze. No, not decays, for other homes or other bands of children, not yet being, nor for age, yet to be arise, and bloom and ripen, and end of all. Welcome everything, welcome alike that has been, what never was, we hope may be, to our sheltered and underneath the holly, to your places around the Christmas fire, where that is seats, its seats of open-hearted. In yonder shadow, we see no intruding furtively upon the blaze, and his face by Christmas day, we do forget him. The injury he has done, as may admit of such comradeship. Let him who come here take his place. Otherwise, unhappily, let him go hence, assured he never quite injure nor accuse him. On this day, we shut out nothing. Pause, says a low voice. Nothing, think. On Christmas May, we shall shut out. We will shut out from our fireside nothing. Not the shadow of our city with the withered leaves are lying deep. A voice replies, not the shadow of the Diocese's whole globe, not the shadow of the city of the dead. Not even that, of all the days in the year, we will turn our faces towards the city. But on Christmas Day, with silent hosts, bringing those we loved, among us, city of the dead, blessed name within, we have gathered together this time of presence that is here among us, according to the promise. We receive and not dismiss thy people who are dear to us. Yes, we look upon the children angels or that light, so similarly to this beautiful among the living children by the fire, can bear to think how they departed from us, entertaining angels unawares, patrons did, playful children were conscious, their guests, we can see them, can see a radiant arm around one favourite neck, if there was a tempting of that child away. Among the crystal figures is one, a poor misshapen boy on earth, glorious beauty now, whom my dying mother said it grieved her too much to leave him here, alone so many years, likely would elapse before he came to her. Being such a little child, being quickly laid upon her breast, in her hand she leads him. There was a gallant boy who fell far away upon a burning sand beneath a burning sun, said, tell him at home, with my last love, how much I would have wished kiss them once, but I die contented, done my duty. Or there was another of whom I read the words, therefore he commit his body to the deep, and so consigned him to the lonely ocean, and sailed on. Or there was another who lay down to his rest in a dark shadow of forests, the earth awoke no more. Or shall he not the seed and sand of forest be home at such a time? The dear girl, almost a woman, never to be one who made a running Christmas in a house of joy, went her tactless way to Sonnet City to be collect her worn out, faintly whispering, could not be heard, and falling into the last sleep of weariness. Oh, look upon her! Oh, look upon her beauty, she serenity, worth a changeless youth of happiness, a sister generous, recalls to life the dead. Die, but she must bless, and heard the same voice saying into her, arise forever. We had a friend who was our friend from early days, whom we even pictured and changes that were to come upon our lives. Many imagined how we would speak and walk and think and talk when we came to be old. Desolate habitation in the city of dead. We seed him in his prime. Shall we be shut out from our Christmas remembrance? Will his love have so excluded us? Lost friend, lost child, lost parent, lost sister, brother, husband, wife. We are not so discard you. You shall hold your cherished places in our Christmas hearts, by our Christmas fires. Tears and mortal hope, on the birthday mortal mercy, we will shut out nothing. The sun, winter sun, goes down over town and village on the sea. It makes a rosy path as if the sacred tread was Fred was fresh upon the water. Few more moments and it sinks. Night comes on, the light begin to sparkle in the prospect. The hillside beyond, the shapelessness diffused town, the quiet keeping of trees and grid, the village people reminiscences, cut in stone, planted in comb and flowers, growing in grass entwined with lowly brambles, round many a mound of earth. In town and village there are doors and windows closed against the river, the flaming logs heaped high, their joyful faces, there's healthy music for voices. Be ungentleness and harm excluded from the temples of household gods. Be those who are anticipated with tender encouragement. They are time, always comforting and peaceful reassurances. The history that united him even upon earth, the living and the dead. The broad references and goodness that too many men have tried to tear to narrow shreds.